Namaste. Let me share a story where Mihiracharya became Varahamihira. Now, Varahamihira was one of the Astana Vidwans of Vikramaditya, King Vikramaditya. Now, Vikramaditya had many scholars in his court. Of them, he had handpicked 9 scholars who regularly used to guide him in various aspects of running the kingdom. These 9 scholars were known as Navaratnas, and one such scholar was Varahamihira. Now, Varahamihira was known commonly known as Mihiracharya. So this story is all about how Mihira became Varahamihira. Now, it all started when one of the queens of Vikramaditya gave birth to a boy. The horoscope of this boy was immediately shared with all the astrologers of the court. Naturally, it was also shared to Varahamihira. Now, every astrologer who looked at the horoscope came back to the king and praised the boy to glory. They felt that the boy would reach much more higher heights than Vikramaditya himself, would do much more nobler acts than Vikramaditya, and would grow the kingdom by many folds. They were speaking all praises about the horoscope, about the boy. Mihira, however, when he looked at the horoscope, he said, all those things would have been great if the boy had a full shelf life, Purnayus. Unfortunately, the boy has Alpayus. He would die as a young child. When Vikramaditya heard this, he was shocked. Every scholar is praising the horoscope, is praising the boy. He had great hopes that this boy would take the kingdom to the next level. But one of his Navaratnas, the most celebrated and most respected astrologer in his court, is telling otherwise. He would die as a very young boy. Vikramaditya immediately sent word for Mihira. And when they met, Vikramaditya said, are you sure? Do you want to take a look at the horoscope again and come back to me and let me know if you change your predictions? Mihira, in his yogic style, very calmly said, my lord, I have looked at the horoscope. There's nothing more to add, nothing less. This boy has Alpayus. He is going to die as a young boy. I will even go to the extent of saying that he will actually be killed. And he'll not be killed by a human. He'll be killed by an animal. An animal which has a sharp tusk or a teeth. Vikramaditya was furious. At the same time, Vikramaditya was also a very sensible king. He declared instantly in front of everybody, saying that if whatever Mihira had predicted, then the emblem of my kingdom would become your identity. Every king has one animal as their emblem. Some people have it as a lion, some people have it as a peacock, some people have some other animal. And Vikramaditya's emblem was that of a wild boar, Varaha. The avatar of Varaha, wild boar, was the emblem of Vikramaditya. He said, the highest honor that any person can get would be given to Mihira if his prediction comes true. Mihira gave the exact date on when the boy would leave his mortal body. Years passed by. The information had spread to everyone in the kingdom. They were all feeling unhappy and at the same time helpless. On the previous day, when Mihira had predicted the death of the boy, Vikramaditya ensured that the entire palace was fortified. Not just the palace, but up to 7 layers. The fort was fortified. There were soldiers all around, and the level of security and preparedness was such that even a stray dog could not come in. On the day that was predicted, roughly around noon, suddenly in one of those dwaras, mahadwaras of the fort, they noticed that a wild boar was coming towards and it had entered the door. Now the commander-in-chief, who was responsible for taking care of the entire security, he immediately sent a group of people in search of that wild boar and ordered them to kill and get the dead body of the boar. A group of soldiers who were extremely well trained went in search of this boar, followed them, and after a good amount of struggle, killed the boar. News immediately spread to everyone within the fort. Almost every person within the fort, every citizen, every salesman, everybody, the news had spread. Naturally, the news also spread to the palace. Everybody were delighted. They thought that they had averted death from the wild boar, and most importantly, they also felt that the prediction of Mihira was incorrect. This news also reached the prince. The prince got excited, so he suddenly ran towards the balcony. Now, as he was running, there was a rope that was lying around. He tripped the rope and he fell down on the floor. There was a thud. People in the palace heard this and suddenly ran towards the place where the sound came from. After a few minutes, when they actually came to that place, they suddenly saw that the boy was dead. And the boy was dead not because he tripped. What had actually happened was, in the palace, there were a lot of sculptures of the wild boar, which basically was the emblem of the king, placed at every corridor, nook and room. This was the year when the sculptures were getting cleaned and repainted. When the boy ran, he tripped over the rope, and the rope actually was connected to one of the emblems, that is a statue of a wild boar. And the wild boar fell down, the statue fell down, and when it fell down, one of the tuskers, the sharp tuskers, pierced the kid and killed him instantaneously. The news came, went to the king, the news went to Mihira. All of them came near the place. Now Vikramaditya was extremely shocked and he was also saddened. But he was also a man of wisdom. While he had pain, he remembered his declaration and instantaneously he gave the title Varaha to Mihiracharya. From that day onwards, Mihiracharya became Varaha Mihira. The story doesn't end there. All the other astrologers who had predicted great things about this boy gathered and asked Mihira, Varaha Mihira now, how he was able to make such a successful prediction, because they were not able to see that in the horoscope. And this is a very important lesson for all astrologers. Varaha Mihira said that they all looked at the horoscope that was given to them. They didn't check whether the horoscope was that of a boy, was that of an animal, or that of an object. He undertook methods of rectification because the horoscope that was given was not indicating that of a human birth. So he undertook methods of rectification and corrected it. Traditionally, what used to happen is, when the deliveries used to happen, it was the midwife who used to take and carry the child and hand it over to the king or the parent or the father. Similar thing happened. The midwife would have noted a time. This time would be based on her understanding of when the birth actually happened. There are various methods of time of birth. We have what is known as Shiro Darshana. That means when you see the first Shira Darshana, when you see the head first, that is one such time. There's another one which is called Bhupatana. That means when the baby drops onto the earth, that is another time. But universally, everybody have commonly declared in the Vedic world, saying that the time of birth is that time when the prana enters the body. Now, when Varaha Mihira looked at it, he realized that this birth chart does not indicate a human birth. And he applied the techniques of rectification, and based on that rectified horoscope, he made the prediction. I hope you enjoyed this story. If you did enjoy, feel free to press the like button. Or otherwise, if you did not enjoy, press the dislike button. If you would want me to speak on any particular topic, feel free to leave a comment below and I'll do a video on that. Till next time, Namaste.